Like, violence is like sex. It's all about the build-up.
Did you get that? So, after watching the movie, I really wanted to give you guys a hug, because I really relate to that type of stress and depression, because I'm just now at that point in my life where I'm becoming really busy, and like it's hard finding time to spend time with my wife and then also juggling my work schedule and things like that. So I wanted to ask, because you guys live it and you keep living it, what makes love last through its ups and downs for you guys?
Couples therapy?
Couples therapy, we highly recommend. And just, you gotta make it work. And we had our ups and downs. I mean,
we've been together 18 years and it's ups and downs. You just, I mean, if you have children together, I think you should really.
You gotta fight.
Fight for it. Doing big effort to stay together.
See, I mean, you're saying, it's like the climax itself is not.
I know this is kind of like a general question. You've probably been asked it over and over, but I'm really curious how this came to fruition. Was it because of the experience on Drive that you wanted to like document this with Only God Forgives? Like, how did that come about?
It was actually because I wanted to work,
yeah,
and not just move to Bangkok and sit and be a housewife. Because I didn't know what to do in Bangkok. So, came up with the idea of doing a documentary about the process of filmmaking, and while I was doing it, I realized it would be more interesting to do a documentary about how our life is, mm-hmm, like when you are together with an artist like Nicolas, and how to like cope with being a family and making films and all that.
Now make it dirty, unique, interesting, never seen before, and violent.
Yes, that we'll do. Throw him to the wall, and go after him. Get him out,
span
him to the
and then the elbow thing.
Or elbow.
Yeah. The sexuality of violence is that the more you're engaged in the build-up compared to the actual act itself. Yeah.
And there's a part in the film that I was really drawn to, and it's when you say, and I think you mentioned it to me last time that we talked for Only God Forgives, that Drive is more commercial, and that's not what Only God Forgives is. Like, it tests like the limitations of viewers, but do you have to like justify your actions in the film, like the characters' actions? And do you have to like pull aside like the crew and like the actors and to explain it to them so they like understand that?
Well, you, of course you want everyone to kind of be on the same thing and believe in what you're doing. It's a little hard when everybody doesn't speak the language.
Right.
But there was it's a great place to shoot Thailand, so it was like, and they have a very superstitious country. We have a daughter who's superstitious abilities, so for us, we fitted very well in. I think that, you always have to test yourself, and every time it works, you have to erase the memory of it and do it again, but differently.
Right.
It's like on every movie that I do, I going into it, A, with the notion that this is going to be my last movie, and if it's going to be the last one, I'm going to go all the way when I can't. And then at the same time, I erase all my knowledge as much as possible, what I've learned so far.
Right.
And that creates a vacuum of various mood swings.
Absolutely.
That Liv is now beginning to get fed up with.
So it's the breaks in between that's the build up to the you to the slicings, and then it's back, and then it's in again, you know.
When I watch your movies, like, I notice the music, I notice the cinematography and all the work that goes into it. When you're watching like other people's work, does it ever like anger you, or do you think it's like lazy filmmaking when you don't notice those things?
I mean, it's hard to criticize anyone really, because just making a movie is very difficult, mm-hmm, and I don't think it's in my place to really be in any way an opinion. I think that I approached, when I was younger, film from a much more idea of what film should be, But after having family and experienced various things in my career, I just became interested in using film as an act of expression, mm-hmm. really, yeah. and leaving it at that.
So that's when you know you have made great cinema, when half love it and half hate it.